Bonnie Laufer is back with some new binging suggestions. We're looking forward next month to having you on our couch. But in the
100%.
Meantime, okay.
Yes, we'll talk,
but in the meantime,
we'll
as we're parked on our couch, you've got some ideas for some new shows, and you've talked to the stars.
Absolutely, absolutely. Always happy to give my opinions here. Okay, well, let's start with 13, the musical, because you know I love me a good Broadway musical. So this is based on the hit Broadway musical, 13, which actually starred Ariana Grande. So this movie was shot in and around Toronto. All of the kids got to hang out at Canada's Wonderland. They had a great time, you know, working here. But the story is based around a young 12-year-old boy. So after moving from New York City to Indiana, he navigates his parents' divorce. He's having a hard time, but he's also about to have his big bar mitzvah. And so who should he invite to his party? You know, it's a big problem here, Bob. You got to think about it. So I actually got to speak with Eli Golden, who is the star, but also Deborah Messing, who, of course, we all know and love from Will and Grace. She's so great. She plays his mother. And so I asked them, I go, what was the craziest or most expensive bar mitzvah maybe they had ever been to? So let's have a listen.
Either this one or because my mom was like, we came home and she was like, Eli, I think I have some good news. And I was like, what? She was like, you probably had the most expensive bar mitzvah ever. And I was like, oh my God, you're right. And, but one of my friends had a bar mitzvah where it was like this beautiful venue. I was like, this is for a bar mitzvah? It was actually a bat mitzvah. So,
okay, yep.
Yeah.
I don't know.
When I was in Los Angeles, I wasn't there, but my brother was there. And there was a bar mitzvah, and in the backyard there was a camel.
Oh, come on. Yeah, I believe it.
I was like, what are you talking about? A camel? It's Los Angeles. And they were like, they had a camel.
Okay, that's a big bar mitzvah.
Okay, listen, California standards. I made two bar mitzvahs, okay? I have two sons, they're grown men now.
Yeah.
I did not have a camel, I can tell you that.
Hey, I wanted to ask you about Keep Breathing, this new survival Netflix series.
Keep Breathing it's a hit on Netflix. It's you can stream it now. It's starring Melissa Barrera. We saw her in The Heights. She was also in the latest Scream film. She really went all in. This was all shot in the Canadian wilderness out in BC. She plays a woman who, when she's a lawyer, when her small plane crashes in the middle of the Canadian wilderness, she's a lone survivor. She must battle the elements and her personal demons to stay alive. I spoke to the lovely Melissa Barrera. I just love this girl. She's so sweet. And I asked her about the survival skills that she learned from being in this show, because they just dropped her in. She learned everything. So let's have a listen.
I mean, I learned, I think everything that I know about survival, I learned from this show specifically. So I hope that people learn a few tips when they watch it. I learned how to make a compass. I learned to stay in a place that's visible, because my instinct would be to like hide, you know, like build a shelter somewhere covered from the sun. And you have to be in a place that's visible, because otherwise how are people ever going to rescue you if they can't see you? Exactly. So I think that is key. Find a clearing where, like, if there's a plane going by, you're visible to them so you can, you know, be rescued, I think, probably.
So we get some good tips here, but now there was a soccer ball named Wilson that we know about, and we recognize the guy who owned it. How does this compare? Again, this is where you have one scene, one actor. Can she carry it?
I think she does a fantastic job in it. You know, like she said, when I asked her in the beginning, I go, you know, you really went all in for this. You really wanted this. And she goes, oh yeah, I fought so hard. They were not going to hire me. She just really carries this through, and very believable. I mean, honestly, I don't even know if I could survive 5 minutes. I always say I want to be a contestant on Survivor. I'd like, no, forget it. No, I couldn't do that. I couldn't do the Amazing Race. I like my comforts of home. What about you, Bob? Do you think you could survive?
No, I'd be done before the first commercial break. Before we go to break,
absolutely.
We don't have time for the clip, but tell us about My Old School. You got to speak with Alan Cumming, the great Alan Cumming.
Oh, God, yeah. You can listen to my interview with Alan Cumming, who I like. Oh, my God, I love that guy. He's the best. But he stars in this new documentary. It's so unique and so well done. And it's a true story. It happened in Scotland. This boy went back to school. His name was Brandon Lee. He enrolled in the academy, but something was just off about this guy. And I don't want to give away too much because you really need to see this to believe that the story happened. But the director John O. McLeod integrates animation and real life. But Alan Cummings, the real Brandon Lee, was interviewed for this film, but he would not come on camera. But he did all the interviews, so Brandon Lee's voice is heard. But
okay.
Alan Cumming lip-syncs.
Well, listen, we're out of time, Bonnie, but we'll link up your YouTube channel for that interview and lots more. And we'll see you ahead
Absolutely.
Of the Toronto International Film Festival as well. Happy Monday, Bonnie.
Happy Monday, we'll see you next month.
Oh, you're the new kid.
That's who you want to hang out with?